When you see that for this Sarawak election, they cannot even sit down and get a good consensus among themselves. Maybe you should advise them and get back to the people again. Thank you.
About differences between groups or whatever, we are just citizens. We are the citizens of this country. What is happening now affects us, not just affecting the political parties or the NGOs, but will affect us. So all I am asking for is to forget that you belong to this group or that group, this party or that party, this place or that place, but together as citizens, please sign this declaration. I have never been on the stage together with Kisya. If I'm thinking about him and what he says about me, and he's thinking about how I threw him in jail, I don't think we can stand together. But we are willing to forget our enmity, our differences of opinion, because this affects every one of us, every citizen. So please, other things are superficial and irrelevant. What is relevant to me is the signing of this declaration. Thank you.
Thank you very much. What is English? So you might go on certain time with it for your president.
We all agree with you that we must be removed as a Prime Minister. The stopping corruption is scary and is unimaginable. But are you also prepared to see the destruction of Amabama Usana, a party which you created since by your own admission, the party brothers, the leaders, and even the Amabama members of parliament are also mentioned in corruption? In fact, I'm not some of them, and they have admitted openly that they will pay by country. Every time that we raise issues of fighting in parliament, they are shouted down and forced to the community side. So the only solution is not just to remove country, but also to remove family. I'm prepared for that.
Not ruling according to the laws of this country. He does not rule this country according to the laws of this country. If he had ruled this country according to the laws of this country, nothing would happen. We won't have this country. But he has not followed the laws. Now, if we, in our attempt to overcome this problem, we ourselves disregard the laws of this country, then I think we are not doing the right thing. We have to follow the laws. If he is removed, then we will have to go back to democracy. What would happen in a democracy if Najib is removed? We have to follow the law. If the law says you have to have an election, you have an election. If the law says you don't have an election, but the people who are in the majority chooses the lead new leader, new prime minister, we have to abide. We cannot tell people, you are not following the law, and we also will not follow the law. That will be wrong. I'm not talking about getting rid of AMNO or whatever. I'm talking about us, Malaysians. Do we want the rule of law or we don't? If we say he is not following the rule of law, we ourselves must not do the same thing. We must follow the rule of law. What happens when we follow the rule of law? That is something that we cannot reject. What happens if it is done according to the rule of law, we have to accept. Maybe when we have an election, the UMNO might lose, or Barisan might lose, or the opposition might lose, we don't know. But we have to follow the rule of law. If we don't, then we are going to have the same problem that we have today, where the government is not following the rule of law. Thank you.
You have set a timeline for the signatures campaign. Is there any timeline so that we know how fast you are moving, where you are moving, how are things being done so that we can proceed towards the ultimate goal of getting Nadeem out of Prime Minister?
Yeah. And there is another thing to happen before the next election. Before the next election. If you can do it today, do it today. All depends upon how many signatures we are able to gather. If we can get a few million signatures, we can straight away go ahead with our plan to adhere to the rules. But if we take a long time to sign, then maybe people will lose heart, and that's not good. So the sooner you sign, the better it is in terms of our chance to carry out this this action. Thank you.
This is that no, that during the currency crisis, people worse, and then really important to Is this not you, or is it GK from Eric Muller or Street in Indonesia? It's true that you are, no? Okay.
So the lead is...
And as I want to ask you, who took away the Arnold's right to approve deals? Was it not you and Eric Street?
Thank you. I mean that I was responsible, because I thought that all leaders of this country, elected leaders, would not steal money. I didn't steal any money. We never expected an elected leader to behave like what Najib is behaving today. We never expected, but we do fear that the rulers given the right to approve or disapprove by signing the act, we do worry that they might not sign, in which case the voice of the people will not prevail. It will still be the rulers whose voice, whose decision we have to accept. That is why we amended the constitution, so that if the rulers did not like the act, they can send it back to parliament. If parliament insists on passing the act and it goes back to the ruler and he doesn't sign it, after 2 months the act will become law. That was because we worried about the rulers, because they didn't have to stand for elections like us. But this is happening not with the rulers, but with an elected member of parliament who has been made the prime minister. He is the one who is doing the wrong things. So I didn't expect this. I cannot foresee this. I could not foresee this before. But the fact is that under the present constitution, if the rulers do not sign the act into law, it will still become law. If parliament ratifies and 2 months later, the ruler did not sign. So that was the amendment. Nobody told me that there will be a prime minister who will steal money.
I saw a lady there. I think the best we give a chance to lady to ask questions.
Thank you. Well, my name is Adeline, and my question for you is, assuming the declaration goes through, how do you propose the succession of leadership after Manjit leaves? Thank you.
Yeah, as I said just now, we need to abide by the laws of this country. The laws of this country provides for the election or the choice of Prime Minister. So if he is no longer Prime Minister, what does the law say about who should succeed him? We go back to the law. It may be that the present party that is in the majority will elect or choose another one of them to become Prime Minister. Yes, that can happen, but there is an election coming. At the election, people can reject or accept the new Prime Minister, because ours is a democratic, law-abiding country. We need to stick by the law, even if it costs us a lot of people. So I will not see, I cannot see who will succeed Manjit. It is up to the law to determine the process of selecting a new leader. Thank you.
Yes, observing the government in terms of governance, because I am a management graduate, so in terms of governance, our main core should be our Dewan Rakyat. And VC and MC of our Dewan Rakyat is kind of inappropriate in terms of privatization. So, in my point of view, what say you, Tun, as in an ex-Prime Minister, in terms of management, because we Malaysians are seriously looking into it. So the vision and mission of our Dewan Rakyat is a bit, we call it sengit, because we privatize it and we talk about money. Everything about money. We lost hope on human rights, we lost hope on the core value of being a human, and also basically, it's one point of view, it's simply yes, history and history. This is something to be concerned with. Thank you.
We live in a law-abiding country. We have rules, we have regulations, we have all kinds of provision to prevent abuses. But no law in the world can prevent abuses done by people who wish to abuse the system. So we do believe that there are a lot of weaknesses in our system which need to be studied to make sure that in future what happens today will not happen again. But I can assure you that no matter how good are our laws, our rules, our regulations, when a person is determined to break or to undermine or to abuse the law, and he is helped by some people who are, some executives, then still we will be faced with the problem that we are facing today. So I agree we should study and make corrections to the constitution even and the laws. But please remember that when somebody wants to undermine it, somebody wants to abuse it, they can always do so. It is up to the system to try and prevent such abuses from taking place. Now, for example, if Najib orders that something wrong is done and it is not done, then he is powerless. But when they have under him, there are people who are willing to carry out wrong instructions. That is the problem that we face today. That officers in the government are prepared to do things which are wrong because they fear Najib. Thank you.
First point, Mr. Chief Minister, you said something about the current Prime Minister outshining you on the international stage. I think that's completely wrong. You were.
Can you come closer to the mic? You were.
The Chief Minister said something about the Prime Minister outshining you on the international stage. I think that's completely wrong. I just want to make a point there. You were in a remarkable stage. You were highly respected in the world. This guy is a mass embarrassment in Malaysia, so that's not outshining you. That is like. Something else, so I think that was the point that you made. My point here right now is, we're talking about how the leading coalition right now, people right now ruling the country, they're wrong and they're not making the right decisions. In the United States, in 2 years, the opposition is going to take over, or the people who go to opposition, do you personally think, as a neutral citizen, the opposition is ready to take over a country like Malaysia? Thank you very much.
That is what you are asking about. But we will have to go through the process of choosing the party or the leader who will rule this country. It is up to the people to decide. The essence of an election is that people will choose the best people to rule the country. But if they choose the worst people to rule the country, then it is too bad for them. But in the case of Najib, he was good until he became Prime Minister. You know, some people are very clean, but when they become Prime Minister, they become very dirty. We don't know. We really don't know. So, people in Malaysia are very sophisticated now. They understand what democracy is about, how democracy works, and I think in future they will be very careful about who they choose in order to form the government of this country. Thank you.
Jadi nanti kita dapat keseluruhan dengan Allah di luar parlimen bersama dengan perwakilan yang sudah lama tua. Jadi apa kesian anda untuk membukakan satu pintu yang berdiri untuk mengambil jadi pentadbiran jalan ini masa sekarang kita keadaan sekiranya kita tidak ada pintu kita masih sabun dan kita berubah kami. Jadi saya itu dapat menjadi sedikit pencerahan. Kenapa? Sebagaimana yang itu dikatakan yang ada adalah semua orang Malaysia. Jadi mereka tidak ada tanda, tidak ada waktu yang diperuntukkan untuk mengambil alih pemimpinan ini. Adakah kekuasaan kita mereka? Persoalannya, dan berlima buat ini, apa mengambil dan yang kedua, satu soal dalam mereka bukan kekuasaan mereka.
Orang yang kita fikir boleh berkhidmat dengan baik. Biasanya bila dia dicalon dan dia berkempen untuk dipilih, dia nampak cukup cantik, cukup elok, bersih segala-galanya. Malangnya bila dapat kuasa dia jadi lain. Jadi kita tak ada cara untuk menentukan orang yang kita pilih itu adalah orang yang akan pegang kepada janji-janjinya. Kalau kita tengok dulu, tak pernah siapa bertemu tentang Najib. Tak pernah siapa kata pun, Najib ni tak boleh jadi Perdana Menteri. Kita pun kata macam itu, dia memang satu orang yang baik sebab itu dia memilih. Jadi bila dia dipuji, dia jadi Perdana Menteri, barulah kita tahu bahawa dia bukanlah orang yang layak dipilih sebagai Perdana Menteri. Jadi saya tak boleh jamin sama ada Tuan Zaki kah, Anwar Ibrahim kah, siapapun belum dapat kuasa, baik dapat kuasa jadi lain. Terima kasih.